大家好，
我是 Stella，
我是 Warren。 今天要为你念的是正文第一章奇迹的真谛 Chapter 1 The Meaning of Miracles 第二节，启示时间与奇迹 2 Revelation Time and Miracles。
启示能暂时却彻底的消弭人的疑虑及恐惧。Revelation induces complete but temporary suspension of doubt and fear. 它反映出上主及教化之间原始的天人相通之境，这种关系会给人极其私密的创造感，致使人们企图通过肉体关系追求这种感觉。It reflects the original form of communication between God and His creations, involving the extremely personal sense of creation, sometimes sought in physical relationships. 然而，肉体的亲密是不可能达到这一境界的。 Physical closeness cannot achieve it.相形之下，奇迹者建立于道地的人际关系之上，帮你跟人建起真正的亲密关系。Miracles, however, are genuinely interpersonal and result in true closeness to others. 启示能促成你与上主的契合。Revelation unites you directly.With God, 奇迹则促使你与弟兄的契合。Miracles unite you directly with your brother. 这两种境界虽不是出自意识的层次，但你仍能感受得到。Neither emanates from consciousness, but both are experienced there.意识能够导致行动，却不具启发的作用。Consciousness is the state that induces action, though it does not inspire it. 你选择什么，就会相信什么，这是你的自由。而你决定怎么做，则反映出你相信了什么。You are free to believe what you choose.And what you do attests to what you believe. 启示是极其私人性的，一经转译便会持不达意。Revelation is intensely personal and cannot be meaningfully translated. 为此之故，你无法用言语描述它。That is why any attempt to describe it in words.Is impossible. 启示只会导向经验。Revelation induces only experience. 反之，奇迹只能导向行动。Miracles, on the other hand, induce action. 因为它具备了人际关系的特质，对现实生活特别有用。They are more useful now.Because of their interpersonal nature. 它对人在学习阶段的人而言，致力于奇迹，成了非常重要的一课，因为一无所惧之心不会从天上掉下来。In this phase of learning, working miracles is important because freedom from fear cannot be trusted.Upon you, 启示确实属于言语道断之境，因为你所经验到的是爱，是妙不可言的。Revelation is literally unspeakable because it is an experience of unspeakable love. 只有启示值得您敬畏，以此心态面对启示才是最恰当且正确的反应。 All should be reserved for revelation to which it is perfectly and correctly applicable. 但是你不该以此心态对待奇迹，因为敬畏含有崇拜心理，意味着此人在造物主面前低人一等。It is not appropriate for miracles because a state of awe is worshipful, implying that one of a lesser order stands before his creator.你是一个完美的受造物，只有在完美的造物主前才应感到敬畏。 You are a perfect creation and should experience awe only in the presence of the creator of perfection. 因此身体不过是平等的受造物之间表达出来的爱。The miracle is therefore a sign of love among equals. 平等的生命之间不该怀着敬畏，因为敬畏意味着彼此的不平等。Equals should not be all of one another because all implies equality. 因此这也不是你对我应怀的心态。It is therefore an inappropriate reaction to me. 身为兄长者，经验比较丰富，理当受到尊重。他丰富的智慧，你也理当听从。An elder brother is entitled to represent for his greater experience and obedience for his greater wisdom.他既是你的兄长，理当受到敬爱。他将自己献给了你，自然当得起你的奉献。He is also entitled to love because he is a brother, and to devotion if he is devoted. 我之所以配接受你的奉献，是因我先奉献了自己。It is only my devotion that entitled me to yours. 我所有的一切没有一样你不能得到。There is nothing about me that you cannot attain. 我所有的一切也无一不是来自上主。I have nothing that does not come from God.此外，我一无所有，这是我们目前不同之处。The difference between us now is that I have nothing else. 就是这一点使我的境界对你而言仍是有待开发的潜能。This leaves me in a state which is only potential in you.除非经过我，谁也不能到那里去。这句话并非表示我与你之间，除了时间之隔以外，还有任何不同或差别。何况时间根本就不存在。No one cometh unto the Father but by me does not mean that I am in any way separate or different from you except.In time, and time does not really exist. 这句话只有在纵向关系而非横向关系上头才会显出它的意义。The statement is more meaningful in terms of a vertical rather than a horizontal axis. 我位于上主之下，你又位于我之下。You stand below me, and I stand below God. 在上升的途径中，我却是高你一层。若没有我，天人的距离会远得令你无从跨越。In the process of rising up, I am higher because without me, the distance between God and man would be too great.For you to encompass. 我一边身为你的长兄，拉近了你与上主的距离，我一边又身为上主之子，拉近了上主与你的距离。 I bridge the distance as an elder brother to you on the one hand, and as a son of God on the other. 是我对弟兄的彻底奉献赋予了我掌管圣旨奥体之责，使我使得圣旨奥体重归完整，只因我身在其中。My devotion to my brothers has placed me in charge of the sonship, which I render complete because I share it. 这和我与天父为一体的说法似乎有所矛盾，其实这两种说法只是不同角度肯定了天父最大的事实。 This may appear to contradict the statement,I and my father are one, but there are two parts to the statement, in recognition that the father is greater. 我能间接地为人激发启示的灵感，因为我如此贴近圣灵，随时觉察哪些弟兄的心境已能与启示相应。Revelations are indirectly inspired by me because I am close to the Holy Spirit.And alert to the revelation-readiness of my brothers. 我便把启示由上而下的带给他们，这比他们由下而上的求取容易多了。I can thus bring down to them more than they can draw down to themselves. 圣灵乃是由上而下的交流媒介，是它使得上主向你启示的直接管道通畅。The Holy Spirit meditates higher to lower communication, keeping the direct channel from God to you open for revelation. 启示不是双向进行的 ,Revelation is not reciprocal. 只可能由上主启示给你，你无法启示给上主。It proceeds from God to you, but not from you to God. 奇迹把时间的需求降到了最低的程度。The miracle minimizes the need for time. 不论由纵向或是横向来说，若想认出圣旨奥体所有生命的平等性，好是得历经百千万劫。In the longitudinal or horizontal plan, the recognition of the equality of the members of the sonship appears to involve almost endless time. 奇迹却能使人的之间瞬间由横向一跃而为纵向。However, the miracle entails a sudden shift from horizontal to vertical.Perception. 这一药为逝者与受者引进另一种时间序列，使他们加速超前，跳过原本需要历经的人生结束。 This introduces an interval from which the giver and the receiver both emerge farther along in the time than they would otherwise have been.因此，奇迹具有废除时间的特殊功能，让人不再臣服于时间的洪流里。The miracle thus has the unique property of abolishing time to the extent that it renders the interval of time it spans.Unnecessary. 行一个奇迹的时间与它的影响所及的时间毫不相干。There is no relationship between the time a miracle takes and the time it covers. 奇迹足以取代千百年的学习过程。The miracle substitutes for learning that might have taken thousands of years.这是因为奇迹凸显了施者与受者之间完美的平等性。It does so by the underlying recognition of perfect equality of giver and receiver on which the miracle rests. 奇迹之所以能帮你缩减时间，在于它有摧毁时间的能力，故能为你消除某些人生结束。 The miracle shortens time by collapsing it, thus eliminating certain intervals within it. 然而，它必须在更广的时间序列中成就此事。It does this, however, within the larger temporal sequence.
正文第一章奇迹的真谛 Chapter 1 The Meaning of Miracles 第二节启示时间与奇迹 2 Revelation Time and Miracles 愿大家有一个圣灵充满的一天阿们，我爱你哟。